guy has cleavage.
Welcome back to Let's Play Kanon Generation on the PC for a second bloody time due to an interruption, as always. Reply normally. I haven't really thought about it. Not the most interesting reply ever, but since it's true, I'm not sure there's much I can do about that. Play Dine and Dash? Well, I don't have any plans, so you're free as well. Well, I don't know the area very well, so I'm not really sure what we could do. What do you mean, rent something? I haven't been to see a movie for years. Years, I tell you. To paradise! She waves them at me. I see you came prepared. Well, like I said, I guess I don't mind. So, what time is this movie? She pours over the tickets.
5:00?
We've got all day then. And where is it showing? Okay, shall we meet by the station at 4:30 then? Let's do it then. Yeah, whatever. She grabs her coat and bag and runs out. A movie with Ayu.
Date, desu.
There's no need to put it that way.
Date.
Go back to sleep. That's a surprise in itself. You getting up at a time like this on a Sunday of all days. Noises?
I don't know.
She's always been that clumsy. Those casual words. I think so. Those vague recollections. Those twilight memories. We used to be friends when I stayed here before. A gentle smile. You know something, Akiku. She smiles again and disappears into the kitchen with Ayu's breakfast things. With my memories of Ayu still so vague, I can neither confirm nor deny her suggestion. Breakfast being over, I pass the morning in my bedroom. Magazines are sufficient to keep me absorbed until noon.
Yuichi! Ohire da yo!
Ohire da yo!
Nayuki's voice floats up from below. I clap the pages shut and pull it downstairs. Huh?
Doushitano, Yuichi? Ramen kirai?
It's not that. Is Mikoto still asleep? We might as well fast forward then. Yada yada yada, Naruto yada yada, Mikoto yada yada yada, room, lunch, Mikoto. And she's gone. And as I re-enter my room, I check the time. I still have about 4 hours left before I'm meant to meet Ayu. spirit, which should be filled nicely by finishing that magazine I was reading earlier. Time to go. 4 hours have passed. Come think of it. This is the first time I've actually arranged to meet Ayu. Every other time, she just popped up out of nowhere. I don't even have the faintest idea where she lives, let alone know her actual address. So if I dropped the connection with Ayu herself, I'd never find her again. Time to go. Speaking this self-consciously aloud, I leave my bedroom. I poke my head into the kitchen to let Akiko know I'm off.
Away!
Yuichi.
Or not. Yuichi's still in the living room watching TV.
Omiyage, kattte kite ne.
Now, why on earth would I? I'm only going out for an hour or two.
Itte mita dake da yo.
She smiles and waves goodbye. I could probably manage to bag a popcorn.
Pamphlet?
Not good enough.
Yuichi, eiga mini ikun da.
Oh, I didn't tell you.
Hatsumimi.
I'm going to the movie theater, the one by the station with a friend.
Shiriai te onna no ko?
Possibly.
Tabun?
I only have her word for it.
Ekimae no eigakan te ima nani o joei shiteru ka shitteru?
How can Yuichi even think that Ayu at this point looks like a guy? She has boobs, she has the hair, the face. She is clearly a girl. I mean, I know it's Japan, but still. Not a clue. What's that knowing smile supposed to mean? As much as I'd have liked to investigate, well, a shortage of time prevents this. Cold again. I may be becoming used to living here, but I'm sure I'll never get used to the climate. If I pause for a moment, the chill penetrates coat, skin, flesh, and bones alike. As I open the front gate, the snow layered on top of it is shaken off and dances to the ground around. No doubt the road is treacherous with frozen puddles. Thanks to the snow, of course, I can't really tell. I allow my mind to drift as I tread the familiar route. I'm not actually going to school, but I'm heading that way.
The wind is the same as ever. Likewise, the cold.
Fortunately, the sky is unmistakably clear. I wouldn't want to be caught in a blizzard, even in town. Who would?
Yuichi-kun!
She was waiting on a bench, but Ayu leaps up as soon as she spots me. She stretches herself to her full height and waves frantically. You're still a hobbit, though. Seemingly oblivious to the reactions of those around her. Can't you behave a bit more ladylike? Is seeing a movie that exciting for you? Hardly that big a deal. She bounces up from the bench and grabs my hand. Right. She runs off still clutching me, leaving me little choice but to follow. I watch her wings fluttering jerkily as she runs. By the way, what movie is it we're going to see? You invited me without even knowing what the movie was? Ditto.
Used
to? When was that?
小学生くらいの時かな?
When I was last here, in other words. Why did you stop going?
どうしてかな?
She frowns uncertainly. What time is it? Not carrying a watch, I have no idea how late we are.
25分前。
We better go in then.
Then, though she had started to walk bouncily enough, she freezes. Are we playing musical statues? She shows no signs of having heard what stands there gaping. She's staring at the billboard.
めちゃくちゃ怖いって評判のやつだな。
That's the film they're showing today. It appears to be the sequel to one of last year's better horror movies. I'm somewhat relieved. This is actually something I'd consider watching. Are you on the other hand still hasn't moved? Is something wrong?Come on, it'll be starting any minute. The word that comes to mind is petrified. You aren't scared, are you? A tearful nod. Don't worry, it won't be as scary as it sounds. It's probably just be a gore fest. She shakes her head. Come on. I take her by one stiff arm and drag her along. Doesn't it sound fun?
でもこの映画にって書いてあるよ。
That's because it's the sequel.
僕前作見てないからきっと見てもわからないよ。
Of course you will. They always make it so you don't need to see the first film. I drag her on in, trailing Iggy's.This is a bit disappointing. That guy in the background, he looks like he's just like... as well as Ayu is like...
そうだね。
Well, it has some unsettling scenes and they do elicit the odd scream or gasp from the audience. But I could possibly write better. In fact, I have wrote better. But it's not as frightening as I expected.Given the original's popularity, I can only assume that it was much, much scarier. Next time, let's just get the first one out on video.
そうだね。
You're sounding pretty calm for someone who was making so much fuss outside.
そうだね。そうだね。
Hey, you aren't even looking at the screen! I pull her coat back to reveal her face. Now, play the scene!Panicking, she tugs it back down over her ears. In what way? How can you be scared of a coat over your head? Timing my action to coincide with another round of screams from the auditorium, once more I try to remove the coat from Ayu's head. The shriek is conveniently drowned out.You haven't looked at the screen once, have you?
見てるもん!
You've been turned away from it the whole time.
見てるけど、でも見てるもん!
How? Okay, might as well play the scene right now!
だろ?
こ、怖かった!
ちょっとぐらい見たらどうだ?力いっぱい目閉じてるじゃないか。
閉じてるけど見てるもん。
せっかく入ったのにもったいないだろ。
返してよ。
せめてこの場の雰囲気ぐらい楽しめよ。
ぐぐ意地悪。ぐぐ
ぐぐぐにも多様なバリエーションがあるんだな。
The audience screams again and again, and Ayu joins them. I suppose the ability to be that frightening merely by people around you screaming might be described as some sort of talent. I pull the coat out of her hands and put it on the seat on my other side, out of her reach.
返してよ!
I thought you were looking forward to seeing a movie. At least try to enjoy being here.I give it up and just try to watch the film. The atmosphere is slightly spoiled since the screams are joined by cries of Ugo! Ugo! And Ugo!
Still in her own way, Ayu seems to be enjoying herself. Ayu staggers limply out of the cinema. That could be something to do with someone wearing herself out screaming and crying. The film being over, we leave the building to find that it's already dark. You didn't even look at the screen once, did you? You're making a fuss about nothing. If you'd looked, you would have seen it wasn't all that scary. Judging by the scene they used in the anime, I don't think it has anything to do with ghosts. Even so, I doubt you'd have found it that frightening. What the hell was it about anyway? And even if you were scared, aren't scared girls just meant to scream and cling to the nearest man? You're acting like a kindergarten schoolboy. Why is it always schoolboy with you? Schoolgirl! Dumbass! Seriously, what the hell's up with you? There's this one guy in Clannad where they keep like thinking that he's a girl and he has short hair. And they think that he looked like a girl and thinks that this girl right here, who's clearly a girl, and he thinks that she's possibly a guy. You're stupid, Yuichi. Stupid, 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 stupid. And her appearance as she makes this bold repetition, wet-eyed, it is as such, I suppose. One could just about almost describe as cute. She looks up at the night sky with a trace of unease. They're supposed to party for today. That was fun. She yelps with surprise, as though she wasn't expecting me to say anything of the sort. I've had a good day. Thanks, Ayu. They're looking troubled. And she nods shyly. I leave her happily waving and head off home alone. In theory. Why are you following me? She's looking apprehensively around at the dimly lit streets as she walks. Look, will you be okay from here? Do you mean, thank you? Just say yes or okay or something. That's because you'll never get home if you just keep following me. Well, what are you going to do? And can you get home from here? Good. Good night then, Ayu.
Bye-bye, Yuichi-kun.
With a feeble wave uneasily, she departs. Is she really that afraid of the dark? So like a kid. She should take a lesson or two from Makoto. She doesn't think twice about sneaking into people's rooms in the dead of night. Well, maybe that would be an improvement. Thinking about it sends a shiver down my spine. Well, that might just be the freezing night air. I better get home too. The air temperature drastically begins to fall when the sun goes down. My breath emerges in thick white clouds, streaming away on the night breeze. I'll freeze to death if I hang around much longer. I set off for home at a brisk trot. Deciding at length to have my bath, I take a change of clothes and head for the bathroom. Next time, let's play Kanon, Senran's for PC.